LG has started rolling out a firmware update to fix the HDCP 2.2 bug encountered on some LG C1 and G1 OLED TVs with a manufacturing date of September 2021 or later. The firmware version is 3.20.80 and has been pushed onto LG C1 and G1 OLED TVs over the air or OTA since yesterday, the 18th of November 2021. Like most of LG's firmware updates, the rollout is done in a staggered manner, so some owners may receive the firmware update earlier than others. If you are experiencing the HDCP 2.2 bug and are too impatient to wait for the automatic software update to arrive on your LG C1 or G1 OLED television, the company has also put the 3.20.80 firmware up on its regional support websites. This is the page for UK models. Just type in the model number of your 2021 OLED TV with Alpha 9 Gen 4 chipset, and you should be able to download firmware 3.20.80 to be installed manually via USB onto your TV. Likewise, this is the US support page where you can download the correct firmware for your US version of the LG C1 or G1 OLED. After installing firmware update 3.20.80, if you go into the video output information screen of your PS5, assuming you have a PS5 of course, you'll see HDCP 2.3 being supported on your LG C1 or G1 OLED. You will also be able to play 4K HDR movies from your 4K Blu-ray player without encountering the indignity of being downgraded to 1080p SDR. Like that time I was downgraded from first class to business class because I didn't have enough money to pay for first class. If the new firmware hasn't fixed your HDCP 2.2 issue, it is probably because you have Quick Start Plus enabled under the TV Management submenu on your LG C1 or G1 OLED TV, so you will need to hard restart the television for the new firmware to take hold. Think of your television like your smartphone. Normally, you'd just put your smartphone into standby without giving a second thought about it. But sometimes, especially if you are still hanging on to an old phone like me, because I've poured all my money into maintaining this YouTube channel and don't have enough cash to buy a new phone, you have to restart your phone from time to time to clear its memory and make the phone less sluggish when you have 20 Chrome tabs open. To hard restart your LG OLED TV, the common advice is to unplug the television from your mains, then wait for 5 minutes before plugging the TV back in. But if you are too lazy to even get up from your couch and walk over to the TV to unplug it from the wall, my man, another way is to use your remote control and summon the user menu on your television. Click on Support, then go into Privacy and Terms. Click on User Agreements. Uncheck one of the items, let's say voice information. Just remember to check it back later on. Click on Yes, and your television will be forced into a hard restart. The key is seeing the webOS logo on screen, indicating that the TV has restarted from cold. And don't worry, all your calibration and settings will still be intact after this. After that, you should have no problem getting HDCP 2.3 across all 4 HDMI 2.1 ports on your LG C1 or G1, so you can hook up a Sony PS5, an Xbox Series X, and a PC with RTX 30 series graphics card to the television, and still have one eARC port spare. Or in my case, two Xbox Series X and two PS5 consoles to take full advantage of all 4 HDMI 2.1 ports on the LG C1, strictly for testing purposes of course. A few people have reported that their LG C1 or G1 looked dimmer after installing the previous firmware update of 3.20.65. But these subjective observations were not validated by my objective measurements at all. My measurements showed that there's no significant change in peak brightness going from firmware 3.20.45 to 3.20.65 to 3.20.80. Any variations you see in these graphs were caused by me carrying out so many measurements: SDR, HDR, HDR Game Optimizer with HGIG, that the OLED panel had heated up. In any case, firmware 3.20.65 has now been superseded by firmware 3.20.80, making it as short-lived as yogurt under the sun. Well done to LG for fixing the HDCP bug just in time for Black Friday, so consumers can now buy a C1 or G1 OLED with the confidence that the TV will be able to display 4K Blu-ray movies or other 4K HDR content that's protected by HDCP 2.2 or higher. In case you're wondering what TV you should buy on Black Friday, I've done a video covering all the key models from major brands here.